Hi, Sophia. You startled me. I thought you were swimming down at the beach.
I was waiting for you, but you never came. You said you'd play a few games and then head right over.
Sorry. I didn't plan on staying so long. But I got kind of sucked in.
All right. Well, that's what I thought happened. Didn't you say you had tons of homework to do before we came to Haida anyway?
But I was fighting so well today. And I leveled up a lot too, you know? Someone's in a bad mood today.
What do you expect? You'd rather play games than hang out at the beach with me.
Sophia? You aren't mad, are you?
I'm not mad.
Do you want to go to the beach?
I swam enough, while somebody I know was having the time of his life playing games all by himself.
So, you want to take a walk through the hotel? I bet it'll be fun. What do you say? Come on. Please? Pretty please?
Well, if you want to hang out with me that badly, I guess it's all right.
Great. Let's go. Time's a-wasted.
Okay.
Boy, she sure is taking forever. Bet she's making me wait on purpose.
Hi, Fayt.
Took you long enough. What were you doing all that time?
Just changing. I didn't take that long, did I? Besides, you kept me waiting. How long was it? Serves you right.
Right.
Shall we?
Okay. Just don't yank my arm off.
the Rossetti's dressing room. Oh, I know. You want my autograph, don't you? Oh, well, gotta keep the fans happy. Usually I'd be pretty mad if someone just came barging in like that. But you're so cute, I'll make an exception this time.
You said the Rossettis?
What? You didn't know our troupe's name? Don't go forgetting it now. Say, what's your name?
Fayt, but...
I'm Sophia. Right. To my darling Fayt. From the Fairy of Illusions, Pepita Rossetti. All done. What the?
Hey, you can't just draw on somebody's shirt.
Huh? What? I thought you wanted my autograph.
Nobody said anything about wanting an autograph.
Huh? But... I mean... What? But I thought... Then... You want my mama's autograph. Papa's? You can't want Canela the Clown's autograph, or Ursus the Strongman's. Right?
No. We're not really looking for anyone's autograph.
Huh? Well, what then? Are you a salesman? Nah. Come to think of it, you look like the kind of guy who's never done an honest day's work in his life. I know. You're here to collect on a loan. And you're too early. That loan's good until next month, they promise.
No, no. Who are the Rossettis anyway? And what's with this Fairy of Illusion stuff? Well, we're not really lost.
Oh no! You're robbers!
No, not that either.
Then what are you? You're not one of my fans. You're not here to collect on our loan. You're not lost. So what do you think you're doing barging into our room like this?
I'm sorry for barging into your room. We were just taking a little walk, checking out the place. Isn't that right, Sophia?
Mm-hmm. A walk?
Yeah, a walk.
Barging into people's rooms isn't called taking a walk. That's for burglars, or lost kids, or stalkers, or groupies.
Okay then, we're lost. Good idea.
So you were lost. That explains it. And I thought you were my very first fan. Oh well, it's not like I performed yet. So, it did seem a little strange.
You're a performer?
That's right. The Rossetti Troupe, and we bring you a fleeting vision of the future. I'm your fairy guide, Pepita Rossetti. Well, if you want to hear it in plain Terran, we're a circus troupe, and I am sort of the host.
Oh, so this shirt with your signature is going to be worth something.
Of course. It's the first autograph I ever signed.
The first?
Tomorrow's my debut. could buy a whole planet with that shirt.
Oh, yeah? Amazing. An entire planet. I guess I'll have to take good care of it.
Hey! You don't believe me!
No, I believe you. I'm sure you'll be dynamite on the stage.
Thanks. I'm in a good mood. So I'll give this little present to you, my first fan.
Huh? A ticket?
Yeah. Our show's tomorrow. You better not miss it. After you see us do our thing, you'll want to treasure that autograph for the rest of your life.
Gee, thanks. I'm looking forward to the show.
Great. See you later, Fayt.
Sophia, it's really fun.
But isn't this one of those combat simulators? Don't you have to fight? No can do. I don't like these kind of games.
Don't worry, I'll protect you. Do anything dangerous. I promise. Come on, try it.
Okay. If you say so, I guess I could give it a try.
Then it's settled. Let's start at an easy level, since you're a beginner. You'd prefer a character that uses symbology from a distance rather than one that fights up front, right? Beginner's level doesn't hurt at all, really.
Okay, I'll give it a try.
All right then, we're about ready.
Simulator. Please set battle system parameters.
What do you want to do, Sophia? Let's start from the beginning. You want to take a look at the instructions?
I don't know. Should I?
You probably should. Otherwise, it won't be much fun.
Okay, I will.
Give it my best shot!
Bring it on!
give it my best shot.
Bring it on. Looks like an even match. retreat!
Let's get out of here! I'll give it my best shot!
Bring it on!
All right, let's play. Computer, start.
Player 1, Fayt Leingod. Character, Swordmaster Adonis Klein. User level, AAA. Player 2, Sophia Esteed. Character, Flair Witch Cecilia Fermina. User level, E. Battlefield, Remote City of Listia. Monster level, E. Setup complete. Continue.
Okay, we're ready.
Preparing to commence. This simulation system may abort a game if it detects that player safety is at risk.
I already know that. Just start.
Confirmed. Commencing game.
Give it my best shot!
Bring it on! Yeah! I'll handle this!
Yeah!
I'll handle this!
Yeah!
I'll handle this! Yeah! I'll handle this!
Yeah!
That wore me out.
But wasn't it fun?
Well, it wasn't too bad, I guess.
Computer, start the next battle.
What? We're gonna play again?
Don't worry, it's basically the same as last time.
Okay.
I'll give it my best shot!
Bring it on!
Yeah! Got that! Got that! Hey! No!
Yeah. I need some backup! Yeah. Is this how it ends?
We lost. Sorry. I was just getting in the way.
Don't worry about it. I'm old enough not to worry about winning or losing. What matters is, did you have fun or not? If you did have fun, let's continue our game sometime, okay? You'll get better with a little practice. Then again, if you were bored, then there's really no point. What do you say we stop now and go get a bite to eat or something? You look pretty bushed.
Yeah, I'm beat.
You need more exercise.
Guess I'm just a fatty.
No one's saying that. Sheesh. Hey, let's go find my mom and dad.
Right.
What the?
Level 2 tremor detected. The system will be temporarily deactivated for your safety. We apologize for any inconvenience.
An earthquake? But Haida 4 is a stable world with no tectonic activity. There shouldn't be any earthquakes.
This is an emergency alert. Haida 4 is currently under attack by unidentified spacecraft. All civilians should follow immediate evacuation instructions on the nearest console. I repeat,
computer,
all civilians,
what's going on?
Remote Station 7, Haida 3, and Haida 4 are currently under attack by unidentified ships. Remote Station 7 has scrambled its own ships to mount a counterattack, but they are outnumbered and therefore unable to provide evacuation assistance to Haida 4.
An attack by unidentified ships?
Stand by for video display.
Believe it.
As an emergency measure, all transporters have been directly linked to the evacuation terminal. Please commence evacuation by following the established route. I repeat, please commence.
Don't worry, Sophia. I'll stick with you. Who could be attacking us? Never seen ships like those before. Wonder if Mom and Dad are all right. First things first. We gotta get out of here. Let's go.
Yeah.
Oh no! What am I gonna do? No, I gotta relax! Relax! First of all, I gotta get away from here!
emergency, all transporters have been redirected to send guests to a special floor, where a large transporter waits to take you to the emergency shelter. After the arrival of all guests at the shelter has been confirmed, the transport jammer located in the evacuation facility will be activated. Please evacuate in an orderly and speedy manner.
Hey!
Uncle Robert and Aunt Ryoko!
I'm glad you're both here.
You guys too, Dad.
What a relief! I was so worried.
What's going on, Dad? Is Aldian attacking?
Probably not. From the looks of their weapons, it's most likely...
Most likely what?
Never mind. We must get out of here. Let's go.
Please wait here.
Is something wrong?
There's a long line to use the transporter up ahead. You'll have to wait your turn here.
I see. We'll wait then.
Damn! How'd they get in this far? Get going! Keep moving forward!
Let's get out of here!
Yeah.
Run, you two!
Uncle Robert?
Just get out of here.
But...
Get moving now! You have to protect her!
That's right, hurry! Don't worry about us! It's all right. We'll be at the evacuation facility soon.
Promise, Dad?
Promise.
Let's go, Sophia.
Okay.
Stay behind me.
Okay.
What are we gonna do? There's no end to these. What the heck is that?
Little lady?
care of that one. Let's go, you two.
Thanks for the help.
No problemo. We should get out of here. There'll be more of those things coming. It's already a complete disaster over that way. Come on! Let's get out of here!
A complete disaster?
Hey,
but
wait
my parents!
Fayt! Forget it! Didn't you hear, Pepita? It's too dangerous back that way!
But...
Forget it!
Come on, you two! I already said it was too dangerous!
Please, stop him! He says he's going back!
What?
Mom and Dad are back there. I have to go help them. Out of my way!
Didn't you hear me? It's an inferno back there!
It's way too dangerous!
Come on, you two, out of my way! Let me go! Let me go!
Look, we'll all die if we don't get out of here. Now!
Welcome to Aruba Shelter 5. This is an evacuation shelter located underneath Haida 4. Please wait in your assigned rooms until the rescue ship arrives. You are allowed to move freely about the facility, but there are some restricted areas. Please refer to the consoles or ask the nearest official for detailed instructions.
All right then. We're going now. Hey, cheer up.
Shall we go?
There's nothing left to do here anyway.
Yeah. I'm sure your parents are okay. Don't worry.
Yeah, I know. Let's go.
Oh, 1 second, please. You've been assigned to room 506. Remember that.
Okay, 506. Got it.
I expect the rescue transports will be here soon. Please try to relax and wait.
Okay.
Thank you. Ah, your parents.
Ah, well, what can you do, eh? Hey, at least you're still alive, eh?
Oh, Ganella. You should really watch your tongue.
No, it's okay. It's just like he said. Even if I went to help them, I wouldn't have been able to do anything. If only I was a little stronger.
Fayt.
Strength, it's not enough. You can't beat them.
He's right. It's not your fault. I bet they were professional soldiers. There's nothing we can do against people like that.
And you know, just because they didn't make it to this evacuation facility doesn't mean your parents are dead. You know, they might be hiding out somewhere. Don't give up so soon.
Or they might have been captured or something, eh?
Ganella!
It's all right. If they've been captured, then you can go rescue them.
Anyway, you'll just have to wait a little longer. What could you possibly do right now? We don't even know what's going on.
Yeah, you're right.
Why don't you go to your room and rest a bit? You're too tired to do anything right now.
Or you could just rest here with us. Wouldn't you feel safer here with everyone?
Thank you, but I'm fine. I want to think things over anyway.
Okay.
Sophia, you okay?
Yeah, I think.
You're exhausted. You should rest.
Yeah.
Don't worry, just rest.
Fayt?
What is it?
Will you stay here until I fall asleep? I don't want to be alone.
Sure, I'll stay. Just relax and go to sleep.
Thanks.
Good night. It's 3:52 a.m. Still so early. Well, what now?
Hey, what's that sound?
It sounds like they're going to make an announcement.
This is an update for all refugees. We now know the recent raid on the resort planet Haida was a surprise attack by Van Deen.
Van Deen? Aren't they that military power that's currently at war with Aldian? They did turn down the Federation's offer of aid some time ago. But there were no open hostilities.
Remote Station 7 mounted an attempt to defend Haida 4, but it was thwarted by a tactical Vendini strike. Currently, the Pangalactic Administration is scrambling ships from surrounding regions, but Vendini forces still have control of this sector. We request that all civilians begin boarding rescue shuttles for immediate evacuation to Remote Station 6. Please do not panic. Refer to the nearest console or attendant for further instructions.
Sophia, we gotta go. You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. A little sleep helped calm me down.
Hold on just a little longer. We'll be safe once we reach Remote Station 6.
Okay.
Computer, tell me the present location of Robert and Ryoko Leingod.
The present location of the specified individuals is unknown.
What do you mean, unknown?
Both Robert Leingod and Ryoko Leingod's positions were lost on Galactic Year 772-12141923.
Lost? What then?
The information system is currently experiencing technical difficulties. Confirmation is not possible at present.
What? Oh no!
Welcome to the Federation transport ship GFSS-12372 Hellera. You must have been through a lot. We will soon be departing for Remote Station 6. The observation bay is located directly through the corridor leading out of this room. Please wait there until we reach our destination. Gravitic warp will get us there shortly.
Watching something.
Huh? You're right. What is that? Something on the monitor?
Let's take a look.
Okay. Oh no! It's worse than I thought.
This is horrible.
Gravitic warp to escape the battle zone. I repeat, we are about to enter gravitic warp to escape the battle zone. All evacuees prepare for warp turbulence.
Fayt?
Oh, I woke you up. Sorry.
No, it's all right. Where do you think we are now?
I wonder. There haven't been any announcements yet.
We should ask one of the crew.
Yeah, good idea.
Navigator, status report.
Yes, Captain. We were cruising at warp 15 on course 231, mark 330, when the gravitic warp field collapsed and the computer detected an anomaly, forcing us to return to conventional space.
Computer, what caused the ship's warp field to collapse?
There is not enough data to determine the cause.
All right. Even if you can't determine the cause, how about a theory?
Prior to the collapse, sensors detected a space-time disturbance. Our database does not contain any record of such a disturbance, but there is a 77% probability it was the cause of the collapse.
Space-time disturbance? Come to think of it, Fendini military technology is based on space-time manipulation.
That is not an established fact, but the Federation Institute of Technology has theorized this is the case.
So it was likely a Vendini attack that stopped us then.
Screen on!
Damn! Divert all power to shields. Evasion course 291, mark 030.
Course entered.
This is your captain speaking. Our ship is currently under attack by a Vendini battleship. Our gravitic warp engine has already been disabled, which means escape is not an option. All power has been diverted to our shields to buy us some time. I wanted you all to know, chances are slim. I had hoped to transport you all the way to Remote Station 6, but it seems that is now beyond my power. All evacuees are requested to proceed to the ship's escape pods. Please remain calm. Follow the instructions of the attendant nearest you as you board your pod. Good luck to you all.
A direct hit?
We gotta go, Sophia.
Okay.
Good. The pod's still here. Get in, quick! We're running out of time.
Fayt, I'm scared.
Don't worry.
But...
Federation ship will recover our pods in no time. I'll see you at Remote Station 6. Now get going.
Okay, you'll follow, right? Promise?
Promise.
Activation complete. Ejection in 10 seconds. Distress signal operational.
Okay.
Searching for life-supporting planets. Planet found.
Where?
Vanguard 3. Located approximately 0.5 light-years from present location. Axial tilt of 35 degrees results in extreme seasonal weather. Existence of humanoid life forms confirmed. The Federation has classified Vanguard 3 as an underdeveloped planet. Civilization level? Approximately equivalent to 16th century Earth. Would you like to review the Underdeveloped Planet Preservation Pact?
Yes.
The Underdeveloped Planet Preservation Pact was established in order to protect planets with developing civilizations. Contact with civilizations that have not reached a certain level of development is strictly prohibited by Federation law. This is due to the fact that contact with advanced civilizations has a high probability of greatly influencing the course of history on a less developed planet. All individuals and organizations belonging to the Pan-Galactic Federation are required to adhere to the tenets of this pact, unless faced with a clear danger to life and limb. This pact is one of the most important components of Pan-Galactic Federation law. It also serves as a guideline for civilian conduct in emergency situations. Violators will be tried by the Pan-Galactic Council.
How long till we get there?
At our present speed of warp 6, arrival is estimated in 144 hours.
Are there any foreseeable problems in getting to Vanguard 3? How's our energy reserves?
No foreseeable problems. An adequate supply of energy and food is on board.
Okay, I guess I'll get some sleep. Notify me if anything happens.
Affirmative. Entering Vanguard 3's gravitational field. Prepare for entry turbulence.
Here we go. So this is Vanguard 3. Since they haven't contacted me yet, I suppose it'll be a few days before they come rescue me. Keep an eye out for danger. After all, this is an underdeveloped planet. My quad scanner's picking something up. Moving at 40 clicks. Dangerous. I should use my replicator to make myself a weapon, just in case. A sword would be a good match for this planet's level of development. I don't want to get arrested for violating the UP3. Luckily, I've gotten used to this kind of weapon in the battle simulators. Not that I feel very lucky right now. I sure hope I don't end up having to use this thing. Yeah, that feels about right. The sun will be setting soon. I better find someplace safer to stay by nightfall. If there is any safe place on this planet. Huh? There's something there. I'll try expanding the range a bit. It
It's picking up humanoids. Based on this reading, I'd guess it's a village. If I start out now... I might be able to make it by nightfall. I'll go. I know it's a UP3 infringement, but this is an emergency. They'll probably cut me some slack if I keep a low profile.
real fight.
I'll handle this.
That was fun. I think I'm getting the hang of this. Made it. Finally. That was farther than I thought. Looked so close. On the scanner. It was just a dream. Where am I? Wait. I'm on a backwater planet. Did someone rescue me?
alright? You were groaning in your sleep.
I think I'm fine, thanks. You the one who rescued me?
No, I just carried you here. My sister, Mina, she insisted.
I see. So you were the one who rescued me. Thank you, Mina. I guess I should introduce myself. My name's Fayt. Fayt Leingod. How about you?
I'm Nicholas. Her name is Mina. You said Fayt, right? Your clothes and your ears. Are you one of Norton's men?
Actually, I've never heard of him. Who is he?
If you do not know who he is, then please, never mind. I apologize for the odd question. You still need to recover your strength. Feel free to rest here a while. Cannot do much, but we do have food.
I'm fine. Yeah. No, really.
No! You should stay in bed!
Please, rest. Don't worry. It is our way to help each other in times of trouble. No problem. Mina, let him get his rest.
Okay.
He looks so young. He seems so mature for his age. Just like Sophia.
You're so round. Who's Sophia, huh? Tell me.
hurts a little, but I can move. I'd better figure out more about this place. No telling how long I'll be stuck here. Wait, where's my sword? Must have it. It must have made him nervous. All right, it's not like I need it right now anyway. What's that?
It's my treasure box. Daddy gave it to me on my birthday.
That music box was passed down through our mother's family. It is the only thing we have left from our parents. But alas, it is broken now and does not make a sound.
I see. Can I have a look?
Sure.
The gearbox is broken. But I bet I could fix this. If I can get back to my pod, I should be able to synthesize parts. I don't think the UP3 prohibits repairing existing devices. Yeah, this shouldn't be too hard. Want me to fix this for you? It'll be my way of paying you back for rescuing me.
Really? Can you fix it, Fayt?
Can you really do that? It is an expensive music box. They told us it would cost a great deal to fix it.
True. With this planet's level of civilization, the parts for this wouldn't come cheap. If I can get my hands on the right parts, yes, and I think I know where to get them. It's a little ways away, but I'll go get them later.
But we cannot ask you to do something like that for us.
You saved my life. It's the least I can do to repay you.
Still.
And I'm sure that Mina wants it fixed, right?
Thank you. Good sir.
In return, do you think I could get my sword back? I won't be able to go through the forest without it.
You swear you are not with Norton and his gang? One of Norton's gang, you will be in even more danger outside the village.
I know. I'll be fine.
Thank you.
real fight!
Yeah, I'll handle this! I'll handle this!
That was easy! Behind? What happened? The pod's parts and equipment have been stripped.
There's no way the inhabitants of this planet know what this stuff is.
It makes sense if they just smashed it up. No use wasting any more time here. I better get back to the village. Hello there.
What a relief! You are well! Norton's gang was lurking around the forest in the direction you left in. We were worried.
Nicholas? Could you please tell me more about Norton and his gang? Who are they?
I do not know everything myself. Norton appeared suddenly in our village about half a year past. He ordered the village to supply him with food. Of course, we refused at first. The village needs its supplies to survive the harsh winter. Norton was in fact ordering the village to die. But when people refused him, he called upon this mysterious light, and those it touched disappeared. One after the other. Carl, Siren, Kurt, all gone. And our father, who resisted until the very end. Of course we told our Lord, But he said the idea of people disappearing into thin air was nonsense and didn't want to hear about it. Now some of the villagers have even joined Norton's game.
A mysterious light that makes people disappear? Right?
Ah, yes. Norton wore clothes made out of a strange material that was neither linen nor cotton, just like the clothes you wear. And his ears were shaped like yours. That is why I did not trust you at first. I apologize.
Don't worry about it. Can it be? That would explain the light, the clothes, and the ears. And it would explain why someone would steal pod parts that nobody on this planet should recognize.
Is something the matter?
It's nothing. I was just thinking. But thinking isn't going to help anything. He may be dangerous, but I'd better go meet this Norton guy. I might even find a way off this planet. I'm really sorry, but it's going to take me a little more time to fix your music box. Can you wait just a little longer?
Okay.
That thing Norton's gang carried off, did it belong to you?
No, I thought it might be, but it wasn't. Don't worry, I'll fix your music box.
Nicholas, I'm hungry. Let's eat.
Ah, yes. Very well, let us eat.
from behind?
What do you think you're doing?
I'll handle this. I'll handle this. That was easy.
we'll fight.
What do you think you're doing? My money!
That was fun.
Who are you, kid? What do you want? This is Lord Norton's turf, so beat it or else.
I don't want to fight you guys. I just want to know if you've seen a little boy around here.
A little boy? Oh, you mean Nicholas. Yeah, he came around here blabbering about getting something back and wanting to see Lord Norton.
Then what did he do?
Being the kind-hearted fellas we are, we gave the stupid kid what he wanted. I bet Lord Norton's re-educating the undisciplined little brat right now.
What?
It's the kid's own fault. Nothing good can come from messing with Lord Norton. Don't worry. He'll learn it's better to join us than fight us. It's a shame. The apple don't fall far from the tree. Idiocy must run in the family.
Rotten little...
Whoa there! Didn't I just say you can't pass through here? Wanna see that brat? You gotta beat us first.
What gives you the right?
Looks like we got another village idiot in need of some education.
Ha ha, a real fight!
I'll handle this.
That was fun. I think I'm getting the hang of this.
So Nicholas is locked up somewhere in here. I better hurry up and find him.
real fight.
What do you think that hurts? Oh, please. If you only spare my life.
I'll handle this. I'll handle this. That was easy. I think I'm getting the hang of this.
Fight!